Stranger Things Season 2 came out this weekend. Obviously, the sequel to the very highly hyped and praised Stranger Things Season 1. This carries on right from where the other one left off, with the kids that are involved in it getting back to normal life, going trick-or-treating and playing with walkie-talkies, and in this series, discovering girls. This series, in short, is better than the first series, because what it does is it builds on the ideas that were put forward in the first series, but it doesn't have this sort of mid-series lag that the first one had. In the first series, there were a lot of sort of flat episodes where not a lot happened, and it's probably due to budgetary reasons or something along those lines, or production issues, but this series is constant. It stays at a constant height and it just keeps ticking over. There's always development for the characters, there's always development for the plot, and it keeps new ideas coming in all the time and developing what's already there. And it feels satisfying. It's a satisfying watch. You get more development for the character Eleven. You see more about her backstory and that there are others like her out there. You see there's a girl right from the first scene of the series who's numbered 8. So therefore, there must be a few other people between 1 and 11 and 8 to discover over time. They develop the plot as to the Upside Down in the other world. I saw some videos online that say ending of season 2 explained. To be honest, if you need that explaining, then you haven't really watched the series. I mean, it's not difficult. What it ends is they're at the winter formal dance, and it cuts to a shot of the Upside Down where there's a big ominous monster looming over it. All that means is there's an ominous presence. They've beaten it in this series, and it wants into our world. And obviously it identifies the kids, and probably Will, the main kid who went missing in the first series, as his way to do it. Simple. I don't think you need to have a bloody video explaining what that's all about. References to the 80s are abound. There's stings from the Gremlins music when one of the little animals that they find, which I won't ruin what it is, escapes. You can hear stings of the Gremlins sort of theme music in there. You can get a nice little play on the Temple of Doom scene with the bedrooms that you'll spot if you're familiar with that film. It's really, really good. There are loads of other Easter eggs and references throughout. I mean, the end of the film turns into Aliens with Paul Reiser sort of reprising his role from that. But it's all done in a good, light-hearted way. No one's sort of winking at the camera going, hey. And it all fits in the plot. It's just a nice little fun Easter egg. And I'm sure there'll be videos where people identify all the things you missed in Stranger Things. But to be honest, if you missed them and you haven't seen the originals, then they don't mean anything to you anyway. So what's the problem? Definitely worth watching. It's 9 hours of excellent TV that is essentially a series of short movies if you watch them in clumps. My wife said to me when I was watching it, oh, is this a film? Because the quality of it was that good, and each episode or set of episodes, if you watch them like that, felt like a cohesive thing that you could watch, enjoy, and then come back to later. So yeah, Stranger Things Season 2, definitely worth watching.